the Style Chronicles. My name is Erica and I like to create outfit and styling videos here on YouTube. Today we're going to talk about the basic black blazer and how you can incorporate it into your wardrobe. My mission is to help you make style simple. We keep style simple so that you can create the best version of yourself, because when you look good, you feel good. If you're watching this video and you are not subscribed, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you'll be notified of all my recent uploads as they occur. There are very few things in this life that are still free, but you can hang out with me on a weekly basis if you hit that subscribe button. So we're gonna talk about the basic black blazer. I have had a black blazer in my wardrobe since I was a teenager. It was something that I wore to school. It was something that I wore when I started college. It was something that I continue to wear today. I've had one in my wardrobe for literally decades. My trusty black blazer is a style staple. It's a basic essential piece of my wardrobe, and I really do feel that it should be a simple style basic for everybody's wardrobe, because regardless of what you do for a living, of what you do socially, of what activities you have going on the weekends, you will benefit from being able to style a black jacket in a multitude of different ways. So it is such a versatile piece that can instantly pull a look together and make it look finished and polished. It's very easy to incorporate a black blazer into your outfits in a way that is not so professional or business-like like we're used to kind of thinking of blazers. So you can incorporate it into your weekend looks and casual looks, as well as some dressy looks. This video will be a predominantly spring and summer based video, meaning I live in Houston, Texas. Our summers are very, very warm. We have very high humidity rate, but I also have to be very mindful of the fact that it is so warm and hot. However, with the AC that we tend to run throughout the summer, it's the perfect piece for helping you to get a little bit of warmth when the AC is blaring. When it comes to cost, there's such a wide variety of blazers available out on the market. I know that the Balmain blazer with the gold buttons, the beautiful detailing, is one of the most sought after blazers. It is extremely expensive. And then of course there's the Veronica Beard style. And there's, if you're into fashion or style, those are the kind of iconic ones that everybody wants to emulate, or that everybody wants to acquire eventually. However, there are a number of different brands that make blazers very accessible to you. One of my absolute favorite brands is Express for blazers. I love blazers. Black blazers are not the only ones that I have in my wardrobe. I have them in a multitude of different colors, and most of my blazers come from Express because they're done very, very well at a price point that makes it very easy to collect. So you can find blazers at Target, you can find blazers at Gap, J. Crew, you can get them at Nordstrom, at Macy's, anywhere, you know, really that clothing is sold. Typically they do sell a black blazer of some sort. You might have to look because it is an essential, so it's not going to be on the mannequin. It's not going to be one of the trendy pieces that they're trying to sell you. It's going to be a more classic piece that will more than likely take its resonance up towards the back of the store. Zara is another really great place for blazers, as well as H&M. For maximum versatility, I would suggest going for a blazer with very minimal detailing. So even though, like I said, the Balmain blazer with the gold buttons, I feel like that is such a style icon, iconic look, that you might want to incorporate that at some point. However, if you're looking to just purchase your first blazer, or a blazer that you can wear and style in a number of different ways, I would go with one that has very minimal details. So no ruffles, no gold buttons. This one, of course, is cropped. You know, just very basic, that it's just a black blazer. There's not a lot of things going on it. There's no real details to detract from the fact that it's a simple black blazer. So length is something that's very, very important. I have on a cropped one. However, the cropped edges hit me right where they should on my hip. So when I lift my leg, right here in the bend of my leg, in the crook of my hip and my leg, is where the longest part of my cropped blazer hits me. Now the rest is really high. This is just a cropped blazer. If you're looking for one that is not cropped and you want more of a classic, true styled blazer, definitely go with one that hits you right there in that kind of hip bone area, and that kind of leg fold. That is your ideal length for a number of different things. You can do this, you know, for a number of different jackets, but that is where proportionally, you will look your best with whatever layers you put on. Clothing that cuts you right there versus anywhere else on your body a little longer, it will just look huge on you, or more of a tunic length. And any shorter, unless it's cropped and purposefully done, will just make you look like you have a shorter torso. And sleeves, of course, as I said, this one is cropped, this is purposely done. But if you're looking for sleeve length, the rule of thumb is when you put your arm down and you touch your fingertips to the edging of your blazer. So you want it to come anywhere. You don't want it to be any shorter than your wrist, unless it is cropped and on purpose. And you don't want it to be any longer than about midway through your fingers. So where your fingers would touch the fabric. And I'll show you on a longer blazer in a little bit. If you do end up purchasing a blazer that is any longer than that, I would just have it tailored a lot. And when it comes to fabric, I would go with a fabric that is more of a suiting material. Express is really good for that kind of suiting material. It's something that will pair with other pieces within the Express line, which is why I gravitate so much towards Express, because you can create a suit really out of anything that they sell, because the fabrics just go together so well. If you're gonna go with like a ponte knit, I would just be very careful. It's a very casual blazer. It does work well, but it pills, and you don't want your suiting, even if it's a blazer you wear very casually, you don't want your suiting to look tacky. You don't want it to look worn or dated or like it has little pills on it. That is just not that. It's a very unkept look that looks so it looks cheap, and you're just gonna come off as, you know, It does not finish your look. It kind of detracts from your overall look when you have pilling going on in your outfit. Definitely go with something that is seasonally appropriate. So wool in the winter is a great option. There are seasonless wools that you can wear year round. However, here in Houston, I would not suggest a wool in the summer, just because it's hot. Wool tends to hold on to your body heat. So if you wanna go for something that's appropriate in the summer, go with a lighter fabric, maybe a cotton, a linen, a blend of, you know, of those sorts. Really quickly, I will share with you my blazers. I have four of them. They are very necessary. The first one is my winter fall blazer. It is 100% worsted wool. I've had this forever, y'all. This thing is older than my kids. It's old. This blazer is from 1993. Yes, I was 9 years old when my mother purchased this blazer and would wear it to work. She worked downtown in a legal office, and wearing a suit was part of everyday life for her. Now this one, it's a size 6. It's part of the Hugo Buscati collection. They no longer make suits. But it was a very well-known, very sought-after brand. It's timeless. It is comes with matching pants that I have in my wardrobe as well, but it is double-breasted, which is one of the most flattering cuts you will find on a suit or a blazer, because you can button it and it really nips your waist in. I swear, I've had this thing since I borrowed it, kept it, stole it from my mom's closet in the late 90s. My second blazer is an Express blazer. So the Express blazer is a polyester rayon spandex blend. As I said, it creates a really nice, that suiting material that's, you know, very durable. It lasts for a long time. This is just a very basic one that I love. I've had for a number of years. I talked about the Balmain blazer and how popular it is. This is a dupe, kind of a take on the Balmain style. It is that double-breasted gold buttons in the V that come down your body that just elongate and make you look really thin. That has the gold buttons on the sleeve. This is a very classic look. But as I said, if you want a blazer that will go the miles with you, you know, definitely look for one without the gold buttons. Once you have that one, get one with the gold buttons. It is so pretty. I feel like it's dressier and it just kind of does something to an everyday blazer. So this one is from Misguided. As I said, it is a dupe for the Balmain blazer. I think it's a very good dupe for a very affordable price. It's under $100. And it looks really, really great warm. And lastly is the one that I have on now. This one is by a brand called Mural. It is from Nordstrom, and it has the cropped sleeve with the cropped torso and shorter in the front. I mean, shorter in the back and longer in the front. The lapels kind of come down a little longer. This is a more bohemian style, something that's a little bit more carefree that you could dress up as easily as you can the other blazers that I have in my collection. So let me know down below where you shop for your favorite blazers as well. So please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notifications bell so that you know when my next videos are. It's free, and there are a few things that are free in this world, but hanging out with me is one of them. So yeah, thank you so much for watching and for continuing to be a part of my Style Prone family. I really do appreciate you guys. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.